I am a USB cable. This could be the future of how we connect all our devices.
We are bringing new technology that utilizes your body as a conductor to connect all wearables and implantables around your body seamlessly.
Our bodies are constantly generating and transmitting electrical impulses. This tech would allow us to use our bodies to connect all our devices as well. Why do this?
Due to the fact wireless signals propagate through air, you can think of it as inherently being an insecure system. We're somewhere between that wire and the wireless scenario.
Imagine that you had a high bandwidth communication with which you can connect all of the data freely to one hub.
So we can actually confine the signal to about a few millimeters from the body.
This would mean that your wearable technology suddenly uses way less energy, and it would make it way more secure.
Do you want to join my body area network?
Yes.
All right. Just by picking up this phone, I am the
network.
I'm the USB cable for this guy.
Correct.
Your body is a wonderland. Could it also be a network? Let's find out.
You don't have any Taylor Swift?
No, unfortunately.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
I'll stand normal now.
This is Hard Reset, a series about rebuilding our world from scratch. We came to Purdue University, which I had heard of as a school involved in basketball tournaments that I did not watch. I don't understand the sports, but I did know it was a big, fancy university. This is Dr. Shreya Sen. He's a professor there and one of the co-founders of Ixana.
Ixana is a wearable hardware company that is focusing on changing human-computer interaction, especially how humans interact with wearable devices and intelligence through those wearable devices on a daily basis.
Ixana is bringing a new kind of wireless communication technology to the market. You're probably familiar with other wireless technologies like radio, cell phones, Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth. These are different because they use radio waves to broadcast a signal out. If you had a camera that could see in radio waves, every Bluetooth headset or laptop would look like a bright flashing light. You might also have heard of near-field communication. This is what your phone uses for wireless payment technology. Ixana is different. It's wireless, but it uses an electric field around your body to transmit information. Using this technology, any devices that are on or very near your body will be able to connect and communicate with each other wirelessly by sending signals through, well, you.
Wireless communication, in the last century, people have used basically radio techniques. However, wires are 1,000x more efficient than wireless. So a natural question came to my mind, can you use the body as a wire? Nobody had really looked into tiny electrical signals like microvolt level and microamps level of current interacting with the body for purposes of intentional communication through the body.
This technology isn't the first time your body has been used to transmit electrical signals. In fact, you're doing it right now. All your thoughts, all your sensations and motor functions, they're just electrical signals.
Our human body have many sensors which are distributed and actuators. But we only have one central processing unit. Why do you think that works? That works because we have a nervous system through which all the information flows up. There is a kind of processing happening and then the information flows down.
Our entire human experience is defined by electrical signals transmitted through our bodies. So we know our body can transmit information. Ixana is just allowing us to send digital signals in the electric field around our body.
We are in the Ixana suite now, and we are going into the room where a lot of the IC or integrated circuit testing is happening.
Right. This seems like chaotic in the best way.
This is our newest chip that is getting tested, and we have different kind of signal generators and oscilloscopes.
As more creative people start to have access to this and play around with it, what are the things that you're hoping they'll do, and what do you hope the outcome of that will be?
Seeing this integrated into health devices would be really cool. Health monitors, small devices, like brain-computer interface sector right now is really interesting. You want to minimize invasive surgery, for example, and just use YR as the communication channel.
What does YR stand for?
YR kind of is a play on words. Essentially, you have Wi-Fi, but we also have wires. It's kind of a mashup between Wi-Fi and YR.
But the Y in Wi-Fi is from wireless, so really it's a mashup of wire and wire.
Sure, yeah.
What does the R in wire stand for?
R? I actually don't know. Wait, Shobhan, do you have an answer?
We just wanted to make it Y. Didn't want to make it WIRE. It'll just be a wire then.
Okay, it's YR and it sounds cool. Let's learn how it works.
People have tried to communicate around the body using the body. We are not the first one. Most people that were trying to communicate around the body were taking existing radios and slapping it onto the body, hoping that it will communicate. So the understanding that the body is a conductor, more like a wear, and you should take lessons from the wear line and not just slap a radio onto the body, is something we had to come up with and educate the community to get to this point.
In other words, send those radio antennas back to Crystal Lake. Basically, our bodies tend to absorb electromagnetic fields, like radio waves. So using radio antennas to communicate signals on our bodies is off to a rough start. But since our body is a half-decent conductor, like an ungrounded telegram wire, you can send a signal around it, confined in a personal bubble around your body. This is orders of magnitude more energy efficient than radio waves, because it doesn't need to radiate all that information in every direction. It just sends the wave around you. It's kind of like strumming a guitar string and letting the vibration travel on its own from one part of the guitar to another.
The strumming example I don't like as much because that is a mechanical wave propagation. And that's not exactly what we're doing.
Listen, David, I went to art school. Can you help me out? This is David Yang. He's gonna help me understand this stuff. At least I hope he will.
I've always been a radio nerd since I was a kid. You know, walkie-talkies was kind of the beginning of that. To be able to work on something that's fundamentally different, it really changes how you think about just day-to-day stuff. Yeah, so the easiest way to think about it is that the body is relatively conductive compared to wood, air, and those type of objects. One thing we're all familiar with is wires. The wire is something that's conductive and it carries signal from one end to another much more efficiently than trying to send that energy through the air. So essentially we figured out a way to leverage the body as a sort of bad wire.
A bad wire?
Yeah, it's a bad wire. We're not quite as conductive as copper, but we're also much more conductive than air.
Don't believe us? Well, take it from Christopher Lloyd. Or Christopher Lloyd. Or Christopher Lloyd. He's apparently a really good wire.
So your body retains most of the wire-like properties, but beats out the wireless by a big margin.
The bandwidth of this technology is currently limited to 5 megabits per second. For context, that's roughly the bitrate of a 720p YouTube video, and already much faster than Bluetooth, which tops out at 2 megabits per second. But this has been shown to work with data rates as high as 30 megabits per second. The question you might be wondering is, what's this going to do to my body? Is it wise to transmit all this data in my electric field?
Yeah, that's an excellent question. Give you some perspective. One of the 7 probably cell phone antennas in your phone today requires about a watt of power to communicate to a cell tower that's a few miles away. Unfortunately, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi uses the same principles to communicate something that's a meter away, which is significant overkill from a power standpoint, which is why it's so power hungry. Our technology couples a very weak electric field on and around the human body. So we're about 10,000 times lower power than a conventional cell phone radio. You may pick up more power just by grabbing onto your extension cord or walking by a refrigerator or a vending machine than our total system power consumption.
All this time we've spent losing and looking for cables. Turns out we were the cables that we needed the whole time. So what's it like to embrace our inner USB cable? Like a lot of modern technologies, you shouldn't really notice this when you use it. It's more about what you don't have to do.
There's a quote that the best technology is when the technology becomes invisible and is going to aid you.
So let us take a look into some of the wearables now that we build.
Oh yeah. So these are like, I think we saw some of these at CES.
Correct. So this is the one you saw at CES where this is a smart glass built by us, mm-hmm. where the chip is on a board over here. And it is interfacing with the camera,
right.
And you can wear this and whatever you see mm-hmm. would be transmitted through your body.
Right.
So you're seeing some glasses, you are seeing some watch-like devices where now the chip is inside in a smaller package.
Right. These are obviously pretty rough prototypes. They're big because they need to accommodate a development board, but consumer products would only need the final chip. These prototypes allow the folks at Ixana to do real-world testing.
We have been doing research on this for last 8.5 years. Right. And what we have is we have devices that we wear around all day,
right,
trying to capture what interferences are we facing on a day-to-day basis.
So you're testing for interference on the device.
I volunteered to be a human test subject for Ixana. The basic idea is that they attach two devices to your body and see how well the signal travels from one to the other when you do things like move around, dab, or fight a vending machine.
You're testing to make sure all the data comes from this to this?
Yeah. Okay. You have like four poses that we are testing. One is this, one is this, and then you go like half and half, dab. Right. Yeah, so that's what I was testing at the moment. Yeah.
How clean is my signal?
So the BER is like the bit error rate is zero. That means like all the bits are getting transferred.
Okay. I'm a bad wire. I'm a pretty good wire.
In general, with this technology, any device you put onto your body will say hello to the other devices and authenticate, just like with Bluetooth.
Because I'm just holding this, this digital signal is getting coupled to my body.
Right.
And I'm going to pass it to you.
We're going to merge our networks.
Wow. They all have their own motor.
And I'm not touching the table. I'm just hovering over this copper tape here. And that's the signal is transmitting.
That's the personal bubble we are talking about. I have my personal bubble of this information. When I touch Nick, now both of us have that personal bubble that Nick is passing to that copper. But if he moves away, it will not be passed anymore. Now both of us have it, but it's not passed to that device. This is a smart glass that we have designed, which has a camera over here that is seeing what I am seeing real time, my first person view, and it then couples the signal with YR onto my body. Do it.
All right, so David is wearing the smart glasses. He's looking at this dapper fellow and then touching this, and we see a video of me. That's pretty amazing. Actually, take a look at the camera. There, it's the camera looking at the camera, looking at what the camera sees. It's very meta right now. One thing I'm noticing that looks like it's kind of low fidelity, but what are you seeing that I'm not?
A lot of machine learning applications tends to compress the data down once they receive it anyway.
Right.
So something like this is perfect for object detection and any sort of AI that you would like to run or train on it.
So explain to me what this demo shows here.
Yeah, so we have a phone and it is currently playing a hard reset video.
Just like every phone should be.
The audio data is getting streamed through this USB cord. And in here is our chip that is putting the electric signal on the back of the phone. On the other side, we have just a regular commercially available earbud, but we've added our chip to the back side of it. So now you can pick up the signal and play it back out through the speaker again.
Again, the copper foil is because these are rough prototypes. The material would likely be replaced with a conductive fabric, similar to what's in iPhone-compatible gloves. Unless you like the copper foil? That's cool too.
If you want to bring the boom in, you can hear real close. I'm just going to touch here. And you hear my voice from the video. And as soon as I stop touching the phone, it turns off. I'm the conductor of all that information.
From there, the big difference would be that you just need to take that device off and it'll be disconnected. No worries about your AirPods connecting from the next room.
Yeah, it's really cool.
That's handy for a lot of reasons, but especially for security.
Yeah, security for personal devices is paramount. In today's day and age, we are living and interacting with the internet all the time. When devices interact with human body, it has to be extremely secure and safe.
No matter what encryption you put on it, folks are always finding new ways to circumvent encryption and things like that, and that's always a cat and mouse game. So we can actually confine the signal to about a few millimeters from the body. And so now you have a personal wireless communication channel that you can connect anything on. We're talking about health devices, you know, even your smartphone data. Now, you might not care if people are listening in on the music that you're streaming to your AirPods, but if you're doing something such as authorizing payment through your smartwatch, or there's always the health critical glucose monitor pacemaker type applications, then it becomes a big deal. You don't want everyone in the coffee shop that you're at to have access to those signals. And our technology, the way it communicates, it naturally keeps the signal close to your body. So if they wanted to hack you, they would have to put their hand on your shoulder or something and hack you at the same time. At that point, you may have an indication that you're being hacked.
The devices that use this technology will be smaller and have longer battery lives than our existing wearables. For example, my Aura Ring. This guy uses Bluetooth to communicate with my phone, and I have to charge it roughly once a week. But if it had something like Ixana's technology, it could last for months, or maybe never need to be recharged with a built-in solar cell. The team here is also experimenting with how we connect devices from person to person. Could you share a file with a handshake or by touching the same table? This also makes possible a whole new genre of lame pickup lines, like, hey, can I join your personal area network? Yeah, I made it creepy, I'm sorry. Anyway, this is a new technology, but Ixana is hoping to announce products that incorporate it sometime next year, so keep on the lookout for that. In the meantime, if you're interested in playing around with the dev kit, you can reach out to them, but you might need to wait a bit. It's currently only available to select partners. So what will it mean when we are all little networks? So picture a scenario where all our personal devices talk to each other in whispers instead of shouts. Between standard encryption and the security of a body network, we'd have a lot more privacy.
I would like people to imagine what the future could be when you have invisible, omnipresent devices connected around you that brings the power of AI from the cloud to you in a personal, secure, and safe manner.
All our wearable devices would be smaller and use a lot less energy, maybe even small enough that we wouldn't notice them. Medical devices like pacemakers could last way longer on their batteries and be more secure at the same time.
Somebody relatively famous once said that every time you have to take off a wearable device to charge could be the last time you use that wearable device. When I think about the future, what excites me the most is our technology becoming not something that we have to see or charge or not drop on the floor.
Then we will have these devices that we don't have to think about. It's on us all the time.
This would enable new kinds of wearable interfaces. Things like AR and VR could use this as a way to transmit signals to headsets or glasses. Eventually, maybe even contact lenses without big, hot GPUs sitting next to our heads. But this will also introduce a new and more intuitive way of just connecting, either with each other or with our devices.
Do I still look over there? Okay, cool.
I just want to have you say...
It's in Laura's contract. No one can look at her.
Don't look at her.
No.